are willing to follow him and do whatever it is that God would have us do. As I mentioned in the article of the Chronicle, he was not formally educated. Rather, at the time of the revolution in France, he was made to help support his family by tending the sheep at the age of 8. And yet his desire to serve the Lord grew more and more and was encouraged by his family. His own parish priest saw that he had a gift for piety, not learning, and he then went on in his own studies to prepare just enough to pass the ordination exams. And I often think that God worked out the timing just right, because France was absolutely desperate for priests at the time, because so many had been martyred, and they were willing probably to overlook his academic deficiencies. The word on the street about his own education was that when it came to his Greek final exam, they gave him a verse of scripture to translate, one verse. As soon as he got the first couple of words, he realized that it was John 3:16. Right? You memorize that one off by heart, you certainly should be able to pass it by looking at the first couple of letters in Greek. As I said, the church was desperate, and they thought he was probably would not cause too much damage, first serving at his own parish under the tutelage of his rector, and then off he went to a small town without much spiritual life, figuring that he couldn't do much damage. But what he did was be faithful. And in his faithfulness, he began to attract people not to himself, but to Jesus Christ. Because that is the challenge for all of us as members of the body of Christ, is to find a way not to be attracted in and of ourselves, but rather to make our lives attractive to the one who gives us strength. The challenge is for us to be attractive not because of our own merits, but because God is doing things through us. Curiar became so well known in that region because he basically ate a little, he slept a little, and spent the rest of his time teaching, praying, preaching, and hearing confessions. It is the formula for a good priest. The word is that he sometimes spent upwards of 10 to 12 hours hearing confessions in order to help people, to be assured of their forgiveness, and help them to learn how to live a proper life of grace rather than sin. One of the things that happens when you are trying to live a life of holiness is that you will not be well liked by those who are jealous. You will not be well liked by those who do not want goodness. One story in the life of St. John Vianney, the curator, is that neighboring parish priests were quite offended that people were going to him to make their confession, that they were going to hear him preach rather than staying in their own parishes. And they drew up a petition. They drew up a petition to the bishop that said that this man was stupid, his unlearnedness was certainly a detriment to the church, and that he was unworthy of the priesthood. Now, deep down inside, all John Vianney wanted to do was pray and to be a monk. But the bishop had other plans, because God had other plans. And so the bishop called Curiar to the office for a meeting. And there were the neighboring parish priests with their petition. The bishop read it to him. John, they think you're dumb. And they think that you're unworthy of the priesthood. Which Vianney pulled out a pen and leaned over and signed the sheet himself. And he said, "They're absolutely right. I am not worthy." That's humility. And the other priests were so humbled by his admission that they repented. He often spent time wrestling with evil. The evil that's manifest in the devil as kingdom priest. He was a holy priest. And he actually wasn't that long ago. By the way, today is the 160th anniversary of his death. He died here, this parish building. I tell you about Jean Vianney because, first of all, I know that I am not a very good priest yet. God's not done with me. I don't hear confessions for 10 hours, but if y'all would like to find out, I'd be willing to. And I certainly sleep a lot more than Jean Vianney. He only slept about 3 hours a night. You would not like me on 3 hours of sleep a night. I'm pretty rough on five. But it was actually Jean Vianney who found me. And I know that sounds funny, because I was visiting a parish church in Philadelphia where there was a novena to St. Jean Vianney. And I asked the parish priest why he had that novena in there, and he said, I've never seen that before. Jean Vianney must have put it there for you, with a wink and a tinkle and a twinkle in his eye. A month earlier, I had actually heard a sermon about some crazy priest named the Curator, and didn't realize it was the same guy. And exactly 1 month later, I opened up a book on the spiritual life of the parish life, and the church library, sorry, the seminary library, and out fell a holy card of the Curator, St. John Vianney. Father Charles Paul, my spiritual advisor and professor, said, see, your guardian, your saint of choice, has chosen you. And so it is that I pray every day that I can be a quarter of the priest, or more, than Jean Vianney is. But to do that, we need to all be willing to join in this holiness. If you haven't noticed, there's a lot of evil in the world. We woke up this morning to more news of shootings overnight in Ohio, shootings yesterday in Texas. People continue to be affected by the sin of others and evil. And the only way that any inroads can be made of a lasting impact is for you and for me to be whole. The only way we can make real change in this world is for us to be able to not only follow Jesus more clearly and more personally and more devoutly, but to do so in a way that those who are curious will come, those who are questioning will find answers, and those who are evil will have their consciences tweaked and pricked, and by the word of God will find themselves changed. That only happens if we are willing to be the radical Christians that Jesus calls us to be. We can set up all sorts of political systems, we can set up all sorts of great ideas, we can go ahead and write countless articles, and we can send out all the tweets we think that will solve the world's problems. But unless we are following Jesus Christ and sharing Him with the world, and helping the world to come to know the love that is available in Jesus Christ, it's all that. All wasted breath and patience. St. John Vianney changed an entire region of France by loving Jesus. We can change our communities. We can change Metro Detroit. And like lighting one candle that turns and lights another, can help to lead to the conversion of the world to Jesus Christ. Evil is the absence of God's goodness. Sin is a distortion of God's created goodness. And they both continue to be realities as long as people are not willing to serve the living God. So let's God's calling you to be. He does not want you to be John Vianney, but he wants you to be the holiest person that you can possibly be by his grace and by cooperating with him. You change the world. Let's be the positive change. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.